Let's see how to use Nginx as a reverse proxy. So let's say that we have an isolated network. We have a few Linux machines on this network, and they can communicate among them, but cannot be accessed from outside the network. The one exception is one special machine, which serves as a gate and a checkpoint. What makes this machine special is that it has two IP addresses. One is a public IP, and this is what makes this machine visible to the outside world, and another is a private IP that's only accessible inside the network. What we're going to see in this video is how to install Nginx on this machine and configure it so that the websites that are hosted on the other machines can be accessed from the outside world. We're going to see two different techniques to achieve it. One is by using different domains, which will be mapped to different machines in the network, and the other is using different ports on the Nginx machine, which will be mapped to different machines. I already have two domains pointing to my Nginx machine, and this is something you can do where you manage your domains by adding an A record. We're starting by installing Nginx. And if we now visit our domain, we see the default welcome page from Nginx. Since my two domains point to the same IP address of the same server, I can visit my other domain and get the very same response. Let's now see how to configure Nginx so it will forward our requests to other machines. We start by navigating to etc Nginx sites available. In this folder, we're going to create one configuration file for each of our websites, where each website is hosted on its own machine. To keep things easy to follow, I'll name the configuration files after the domains. So let's start with the first file. And I'm going to keep the configuration to a minimum, only what's really necessary. So we need to define the port Nginx will listen to. Then we need to define the server name, which is basically the domain in the URL. Then we need the location context. And that's where we define the proxy using the proxy pass directive. Here we need to specify the target, which in our case is the IP address of the machine hosting the first website. Let's save this file and exit. And I'll duplicate the file we just created and name the new copy according to the name of the second domain. Let's now edit this second configuration file. And this one needs to kick in when the domain in the URL is the second domain. And we also need to change the target machine, so it will be the machine hosting the second website. So we're done with writing our configuration files. We now need to create symbolic links to these files in the sites enabled folder. We use the ln command to create these symbolic links, and they need to point to the files in sites available. Let's also create a symbolic link to the second configuration file. And now that we have our symbolic links, we need to reload our Nginx configuration, which can be done with Nginx-S reload. Let's try to visit our first domain now. And we can see the website hosted on the first machine. I remind you that this machine doesn't have a public IP and cannot be accessed directly. We're only able to see this website thanks to Nginx's proxy pass. Let's try to visit our second domain. And we see our second website from the second machine. Let's see how to achieve something similar by using different ports on Nginx. Let's duplicate again our configuration file, and I'll call the new copy port 7000. Here I want to receive requests that use an IP address, not a domain. Notice that this is going to be the IP address of the Nginx machine. That's the only public IP address we have, so that's the one we use. Don't write here the private IPs of the specific machines. And we also want to change the port of this configuration. This is going to be for requests on port 7000. So let's listen on this port. What doesn't change is the proxy pass, since it needs to keep pointing to the machine that hosts the first website. Let's now duplicate the second configuration file, and for this one I'll use port 7001. And once again, we need to update the port and the server name. Let's create symbolic links to the two new files. And let's reload our Nginx configuration again. And we can now use ports 7000 and 7001 to visit our websites.